Conservatives are furious at Parler right now after Parler admitted last week that they, in fact, were turning over their users to the FBI, ratting them out, snitching on them, as Parler users are saying, all the way back in December, when those individuals would post horrendous or potentially violent things, especially in the lead up to the January 6th insurrection. Now, this is kind of a fun story with a lot of different things to understand here. First and foremost, let's not forget that last week you once again had tech giants, including Mark Zuckerberg. They went and testified before Congress. They talked about, oh, well, gee whiz, there's not much we could have done about the insurrection and people posting about it. Really, you should blame Trump for all that. It's certainly not us. So in response to that, Parler, who was not a part of all of this, they released a statement and said, hey, we were actually the good guys here because we were working with the FBI and turning over our users. So, ha. They kind of wanted to get a little bit of a, like, we owned you moment in. And they ended up owning themselves. That's what's so great about this. Now, don't get me wrong. Parler is the only one who clearly did the right thing. Like, that's what's so screwed up about this. Parler, that right-wing conservative alternative to Twitter, they did what they should have done, right? They saw these violent posts, they understood the threat, and they said, hey, FBI, here you go. You need to look at this. And the FBI said, well, thank you very much. We will look into this. That's how the other outlets should have acted. But they didn't. And Parler did. And Parler bragged about it. But Parler forgot to take into account the fact that their users are not exactly the most stable people out there. I mean, if you're already having to report them to the FBI, you can pretty much go ahead and guarantee these aren't fine, upstanding citizens who will applaud your efforts to reduce crime in the United States. No, especially when it involves turning them in. So Parler users, these hardcore conservatives, have been lashing out at the social media outlet for the last few days, again, calling them snitches, accusing them of being a part of the deep state now because they're working with the FBI to get rid of the crazies from their platform. So, unfortunately for Parler, they do the right thing one time. Like, okay, we're going to do the right thing. We're going to be good people. We're going to follow the letter of the law. And now they're getting punished for it because that's actually not what conservatives want. Conservatives are not actually the party of law and order. They're not the party of law enforcement either. They're the party of let me do whatever the hell I want. And if I get in trouble, I'm going to scream cancel culture. That's what the Republican Party is. That's what these Parler users are understanding now. And they're revealing about themselves. And Parler is just caught in the crosshairs like, well, damned if we do, damned if we don't. One of today's video sponsors is Privacy, and right now, they have a wonderful offer for all of our Ring of Fire viewers. Go to privacy.com/ROF, sign up for your Privacy account, and you will receive $5. Privacy.com, their service is absolutely one of the most vital in an online world today, especially during the pandemic. Everyone is encouraged to stay home, so we're ordering more things online. And so your bank account information is more vulnerable than ever. Privacy gives you security. This is a product that I use all of the time. And here's why. If you have ever had your bank account information stolen, if it's been part of a data leak, that is a massive headache trying to get your money back, trying to repair your credit. Privacy helps take away some of that concern. What Privacy does is it provides a browser extension, or you can go right into the website or into the app, and it can create a virtual bank account or credit card number. It could be a temporary number that only is used one time, or it can be merchant specific, meaning you can create a bank account card that only works for one particular website. So if that account happens to get hacked or has a massive data breach, that card number no longer works with any other website. That is how privacy helps protect your bank account information in an increasingly insecure online world. So again, go to privacy.com/ROF. You get $5 free just for signing up. Or if you don't want to type it in, just click the link at the top of the video description below.